What's going on, y'all? So if y'all watch, I'm sorry. If y'all watch my What It Is video, and I don't even know if this will be up before the What It Is video, but in the What It Is video, I had mentioned that I might do a story time on how I almost died at the Indiana Dunes when I was in high school, a senior in high school, okay? And I was like, let me do this in a separate video. So listen, picture it. It was 2005 or about to be 2005. Yeah, it was 2005. I was 18 years old and I was in high school, okay? And I was a senior. So basically what wound up happening is I had all of my credits. And I used to think back in the day, you know, when you look at TV, they used to put it out there, and I think they probably did do this, but they didn't do this. I don't think they do this anymore. Like, if you have all your credits, I thought that you can just go ahead and not have to take any more classes. This is when I was younger. I didn't know nothing about high school because it was my first time going. So I'm taking off my stuff. I'm taking all my information from what I've seen on TV. You know, you only take the amount of classes that you need, not that you have to fill up the whole day or whatever. But in our school, you had to fill up your whole calendar. So regardless of if you had all your credits, you still have to pick some other stuff, you know what I'm saying, to fill up your whole day. It wasn't I just need two or three classes, I'm gonna just take those two or three classes and then I'm gonna go home early. No, you had to fill it up. And so one of the classes that I took was environmental science, all right? And I was probably like, me and probably maybe a couple of other people who were upperclassmen were in there. Everybody else was like either eighth grade, because my school was a magnet school, and Whitney Young Magnet High School. My school had, I think, seventh and eighth graders there too, you know, for the gifted program. And so we had some seventh and eighth graders in there, freshmen in there, some sophomores in there, but it wasn't that many like seniors. It probably was a couple of us, okay? And so at this point, you know, one of the trips that we took, my teacher suggested that we go to the Indiana Dunes, you know. And so at this point, I'm like, hey, I'm thinking it's going to be something cool, something fascinating. And I've never heard of the Indiana Dunes at this point, okay. And I'm thinking, oh, it's just a place that we go into or whatever. We go walk around, look at some stuff or whatever, because I'm pretty sure it's got to be related to environmental science because this is an environmental science class, right? Baby, I get to the classroom. We get ready to go. We get on the bus. I'm cool. I have on Nike shoes, okay? Air Force Ones, white ones, all right? They wasn't so white. They was already worn in a little bit, you know what I'm saying? So I didn't care about getting them messed up. But the fact of the matter is they didn't have a grip on the bottom, you know, like if I had on some boots, okay, like some Tims or some hiking boots or whatever, which would have came in handy for me, okay? And I had on a fleece jacket or whatever. Baby, I just thought we was going to a regular thing. I did not know when we pulled up that we was going to something that was going to be outside and dealing with a whole bunch of sand and dealing with a whole bunch of hills and going up and going down and hiking a trail here and there. And I got to keep up. Now, when we get there, it was a group of other people that was there. It was another class that went with us. So they split us up. And our class took one direction around the dunes or whatever. And the other class went an opposite direction. They went a different course. And the different course, I wish I would have been on that bitch, okay? Because, listen, as I'm getting into it, I'm like, okay, this is fine. You know, I need to exercise, whatever. Because, listen, when I was in college, I mean, high school or whatever, I was a big girl too. You know what I'm saying? I probably wasn't as big as I am now, but I was a big girl at that point too. At my current rate, I'm probably like 50, 60 pounds overweight. Well, I'm more than that overweight, but 50, 60 more pounds than I was, heavier than I was when I was in high school. Either way, I was still a big girl. You know what I'm saying? And baby, when I tell you the fat and the weight and everything played the fuck against me, okay? I said, what is this? So we hiking, we walking or whatever. I don't got no problem with walking, whatever. It's fine. Okay. You know, I be doing, girl, I used to run up in gym. Okay. My big ass used to be shoom, 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 shoom. Okay. You know, I had no problem doing the little fitness test and doing all that stuff. Don't think just because you're a big girl or a big person that you can't get your little speed on a little bit. I mean, we probably get tired quicker than most, but you know, we can still do a little something, something. Okay. And I can stick it out. You know what I'm saying? Even though I'm about to pass the fuck out, I can still push through it, you know? Baby, I'm tired from hiking, okay? We walking alone, and next thing you know, I realize this is not what I thought we was going to do. We're outside, we're with nature, and I understand now why they call it the dunes, okay? When I tell you there was sand hills going up, then you had to come down, and then you had to climb on this, and then you had to swivel on that, and then you had to hike some more, and then you had to climb up some more, and then you had to be careful because then towards the end, it was this big steep hill that you had to come down, and I was so scared of just rolling down, okay? I was so embarrassed because I was tired. I was so tired. By the end of that, by the middle of that shit, I was sweating my ass off. It was cold outside. I think it was like, was it 2005 or was it 2004? Was it at the beginning? No, it was the beginning of spring, but it was still cold. It wasn't that cold, but it was still cold enough that you needed a jacket. And my body had generated so much heat, bitch, that I was sweating. I'm breathing hard. I'm like, damn, ain't nobody gonna ask me, Ashley, do you need some water? Ashley, you okay? My teacher had to stay behind with me because, listen, I was the last person. And if you know, let me tell you something. It's one thing being the biggest person in your class or whatever, okay? That's one thing. You got to deal with that. Sometimes you might get bullied. And thank God I didn't experience bullying in high school, okay? I experienced a little bit, like when I say a little bit of it in grammar school by this one particular person. But when I hemmed his ass up on the fence, nothing happened ever since. You know what I'm saying? Imagine he was smaller than me. So it took nothing for me to grab him and put him on that fence like that, bitch. Troy. Yes, I'm putting your fucking name out there, Troy. But anyway, bitch, I never forget that shit because I had a bad day that day and he was talking that shit, bitch. He was talking that shit. And I just said, fuck it. You ain't gonna say shit else to me, nigga. What you gonna do? Had him hemmed up. He looking like this. All four of his eyes. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, the teacher had to stay behind with me because I was in the back. Everybody else is like all the way up, damn near finished with the course. I'm still in the back trying to climb up the fucking dunes. It's sand. I didn't have the right shoes. I'm not the right fucking size for this shit. I am hot. Like, I am sweating. I am perspiring everywhere. Baby, I felt like I was gonna have a fucking heart attack, okay? I said, I know I'm not gonna die out here. I am not about to die out here. Baby, I was in my head thinking, I wanted to cry so bad. It's not funny, but I was just so embarrassed because, like I said, I'm the biggest person in the class. I'm probably the biggest person there. And that was the one time that I really felt so insecure about my size and everything. Like, I really felt like a fat bitch. I really did, because it played so much against me. I give myself credit for pushing through because I had to push through because there was no way to... No car or no plane or no nothing was coming out there to get me. You know what I'm saying? So I had to continue forward. So, you know, I had to hunker down and use all my strength to climb up the goddamn sand dunes and get a footing in that and slide on fucking down and go ahead and muster up the strength to go ahead and go through all this stuff. Baby, it was the most humiliating thing ever to have your whole class and everybody else so many feet and yards ahead of you, and you are back here sweating like a fat pig, okay? Baby, I was like, never again. When we finished that, I was silent. I was silent. It took forever. I've never been so out of breath. I don't even think my heart was beating so fast. It took so long for my shit to come down to being cool. You know what I'm saying? Back to the level that it's supposed to be. And so I can breathe normally. I literally thought I was going to die. I literally thought I was going to die. Baby, when we got to the bus and I got on that thing, I went straight to the back, got in my seat, sat by the window, and just looked out the window with my head down a little bit. And I was just thinking in my head, this, never again. I should have said no. I shouldn't have even told my mom that we want, and she shouldn't even sign the permission slip. Like, what was I thinking? I should have did some research on what this was. I really did. I played myself. Baby, that was probably, out of my whole high school career, that was the most humiliating thing, okay? Because it's a group of people. And you know how kids can be cruel. So, I don't know. In my mind, I'm like, I'm thinking, they up there talking shit probably about me. Like, look at this fat bitch or whatever. She can't do shit or whatever. Look at her. Blah, blah, blah. I don't know. You know, your mind gets to overthinking. And that's probably not even what's going on. And you seeing people just breezing through. And you like, damn. Damn. I was really considering, like, bitch. Girl, no more food for you. Okay? We got to get this under control somehow, some way. Okay? Listen, it was humiliating. All right? I made it through. I give myself credits and props for pushing through because I wanted to give up so many times. I wanted to give up and I wanted to just sit there and break down and cry. But my pride would not let me cry and my ego would not let me cry in front of these people. Okay? These people that don't really know me and probably don't give a damn about me. So, girl, that's the time I almost died. I really almost died. That was my most humiliating moment. My most humiliating moment of my high school career. It really was. It really was. I said, bitch, you should have looked up what the fuck Indiana Dunes was. I don't know why. I thought it was a theme park or something like that. I thought it was going to be a theme park. Now I think it's like a beach resort or something like that too. But baby, listen, no. When I got there, the rude awakening, that fucked me up. Fucked me up. Put down in the comments your experience where you was humiliated, your body worked against you, or whatever. Girl, I will never forget that. I was traumatized. But anyway, you guys tell me how you feel, and I will see you guys later. Peace.